Hi, ViteConf. I'm Matt Biilman, CEO and co-founder of Netlify. Netlify enables the world's developers to unlock the power of the web. We are enterprise-grade front-end cloud platform that helps you build, deploy, and operate websites, web apps, web store, online. But today I'm going to talk a bit about the evolution of the space we are in. And I'm going to start back in 2016 when I gave a talk at Smashing Magazine's conference here in San Francisco about the modern front-end stack. And there was a talk where I coined the term Jamstack and talked about the stack moving up a little. I know there's been a lot of back and forth on what that word actually meant, and we've definitely let the community run with it for a bit. But back then, one thing that was clear to me was that it wasn't about static sites. Then we would just have called it static sites. It was really about this idea of decoupling, and specifically decoupling the front end from the back end, making sure that you could build the actual web UI with modern built tools aimed at web developers and web technologies. It happened that at a time where there was a sense that the sort of monolithic N-tiered stack that we worked with generally had become really, really complex to operate and scale. There was caching at all these different layers. There was a lot of risk of security and downtime and so on. And it was just hard to reason about the stack. It was really complex. We proposed this idea of like really decoupling the build time from the runtime, the front end from the back end, lean on APIs for the back end, and talk to APIs either during the build or at runtime, and sort of really move from a monolithic stack, WordPress, Drupal, Adobe Experience Manager, or any of those where the front end was just sort of an afterthought from the framework driving your business logic, and to a stack where you could really build a self-standing web app distributed really close to the user and then talk to all these different apps and services. I saw the key components back then as the build tools you would use, Git as the driver of the workflow, frameworks as this web native layer that you would work in that was based on technologies that was really aligned with the core web platform, and then APIs and content delivery networks as, on the one hand, the services you would build your functionality around and the delivery mechanism to get your web experiences really close to the users. But back then, in each of those buckets, the world really looked very different, right? Like the main build tools at the time was Grunt and Gulp, for those who remember, sort of very simple task runners. There was the static site generators like Hugo and Jekyll that were actually not built with web technologies, but came more out of like the typical world of CMSs and backend tools. The API landscape had the first sort of headless CMSs like Contentful and Prismic trying to build headless content infrastructure. And in the framework landscape, it was still at the time when I gave this talk pretty dominated by Angular and Ember with React just starting up. Now we moved from that to sort of really this idea of a Vue framework where React and Vue over time became like the two most popular frameworks. But frameworks, as we'll see later, in a very different sense than how we talk about them today, right? Like they were really about running the UI in the browser. And you would have this set of tools like routers, and state management libraries, and all these small composable pieces that you could put together with build tools and compilers and bundlers, however you wanted. The downside was that you kind of had to compose together a bunch of different tools for every project without like a clear guideline to how you get started. So that's why we started seeing these meta frameworks emerge. It's kind of funny how the terminology has shifted, right? Like, but back then we were really talking about Gatsby, Next, and Nuxt as meta frameworks because they took these UI frameworks and then they gave some structure around it. Gatsby was the first one that came to popularity with the idea of like hydrating every single page you landed on as a single page application and then sort of taking over. Next and Nuxt took that same approach. And then over time, like Next kind of really grew to become pretty dominant in the space. and also sort of really moved from this idea of one way of operating to all these different rendering and operation modes, static, SSR, ISR. We have the page router, and then they started, like, the team started introducing the app router for more application-like routing patterns with layers, nested layouts with streaming. We had the whole movement towards, like, bundling in a strong opinion on state from the server with React server components that are sort of, like, serialized rendering instructions sent to the virtual DOM in the client. We have like the partial pre-rendering that's starting to make its way in, where you stream a request and like the static fast part you deliver immediately, but then you keep the request open and start doing background processing from the edge layer to the backend layer and start like pushing in those rendering instructions as RC once the whole thing is ready. And I think we've gotten to this point where it feels like in a certain way we've reinvented the monolith spanning both frontend and backend, introducing a lot of state and a lot of complexity. When I think back on this old chart and all the different caching layers and elements in between, and then go look at the next year's documentation for caching, conceptually, like this looks a bit cleaner, but conceptually it's very similar, right? Like you have the router cache and the full router cache and the memoization and the data cache and fetch caching and all these different layers, and that's becoming really hard to reason about. And the other day, like I just typed up a bit of my thoughts in a tweet that I saw immediately resonated with a lot of interesting people in the space, just sort of sharing this observation that I think in the initial phases of this move to front-end frameworks and meta frameworks, we saw a big shift in what we could actually build for the web, in the performance and the dynamic elements of the experiences. But perhaps in the last 3 to 4 years, we've added a lot more complexity. It's become harder to reason about what we are, like the tools we're using. And at the same time, I don't think we've seen any big step change in what we're building. So if we're still building many of the same things that we also built 5 years ago, how can we make the web simpler again? How can we then free up complexity budget to spend it on innovation and whole new patterns? So I think a key piece in that is changing our mindset from frameworks and to smaller composable primitives. Smaller, simpler primitives that are easy to reason about in isolation, but that we can compose together and evolve independently. And fortunately, I'm not the only one thinking this. There's sort of a whole emerging landscape of new frameworks that all seem to embrace this idea in different ways. Astro is one of them. A framework that really emerged out of the idea of like, what if we don't try to do everything at the same time, but focus on being a framework for content-driven websites, where you typically have a piece of the content that turns into a web page with a URL. And what if we use this idea of dynamic islands? We say most of this is actually just like an HTML page. Doesn't need to change a lot. And then we might have some specific interactive elements that we can swap in that can be powered by a component library. And maybe those can even be server islands. So they can load in after the first static page has popped up, populate from the server, and then either be interactive or non-interactive. You could think about like a product page where you have a set of recommended products for a specific visitor. Those would be in an island. Or you can think about like the cart element being a little dynamic island, maybe totally client rendered. Astro doesn't have any big opinion around like the state for any of those elements. But there's a lot of different options. One of them is signals that got popularized maybe by SolidJS, but made its way into Preact and Angular, and is now starting to become a built-in browser primitive for state management and updates. So this is a small example of using signals to have one counter island that you can click, and another island that displays the same count across the page. But again, you could also use nano stores or any of the other state management techniques in place. Astro don't have an opinion around it as such. And Astro also views the UI frameworks, again, not as big vertical frameworks deciding both of server rendering and client rendering and stage management, but as component libraries. And you can easily make islands in Lit or Solid or React and so on. It also views platforms like ours at Netlify as something that has a set of core primitives that you can deploy into in different ways, and comes with a bunch of adapters to any platform. I obviously think you should always use the Netlify adapter, but I like the fact that there's this like easy pluggable ecosystem around Astro, and that it feels modular instead of monolithic, component-based instead of monolithic, composable. TanStack Start is another emerging framework in alpha right now that actually really has started its life as a whole set of different components, in this case, really geared towards the other end of the spectrum, where Astro might say like piece of content maps to a page. TanStack is more about like single page applications and dashboards and application use cases with an in-client router. It's a really cool emerging framework, but again, build it out of a whole set of individual composable primitives that you can also use outside of TanStack Start, and build upon a set of primitives that's emerging, like Vite, obviously, we're here because of that, Nitro and on.js. Remix, again, another example that started up as a venture-backed startup and kind of building it more of a monolithic framework, then got acquired by Shopify and got a maybe kind of freedom to say, we just need to build great web infrastructure. We don't need to dominate the space and capitalize on it. And after that, they went to Vite and say like, well, maybe Remix should actually just be a Vite plugin instead of building all of its own compilation and bundling layer and hot module reloading layer. And a bit after that, they said, okay, maybe Remix should just kind of merge into React Router and add some abilities to do data fetching and server-side rendering, but keep the whole surface area really small and fit into that original world of composable React applications you can sort of put together yourself. Vite is another framework that's really interesting. Sits very close to sort of the core of Vite, but adds some opinions around how to do routing and data fetching and pre-rendering. Again, you'll see that you can use any of the UI frameworks, and it again starts treating that layer as just a view framework for rendering dynamic components in one way or the other, in the client or in the server. Again, really based on composable primitives, and again centered around Vite. We've sort of seen Vite being at the center of this whole motion, this whole explosion of frameworks that are more targeted, that are smaller, more focused, and more composable. And we've also seen Vite innovate in that space through the environment API that's really geared towards the idea of like each of these frameworks might write code and build concepts that deploy into different providers like Netlify Edge Functions or Cloudflare Workers or a service worker in the browser. In this way, we can start having a base of like a base of shared compilation and a local dev server environment that maps really well onto all the primitives that we build across the different cloud providers and front-end cloud providers. So in short, I think we can make the web simpler if we start moving from thinking that everything should be one dominating monolithic framework to frameworks that are more specialized and takes a more specific direction. I think if we move towards composable primitives instead of monolithic frameworks, we start getting a healthier open source ecosystem, and we start being able to reason about those primitives in isolation. We can lean more into the web platform and make sure every primitive you learn makes you better at building for the web in general. And we can start focusing on simple concepts that are easy to reason about versus things that might be easy to write but hard to reason about, and move from frameworks to primitives and a simpler web, hopefully still made easy by great developer experiences around it. That's what we're trying to do at Netlify, and we feel that the whole Vite community is an awesome partner in that. Thank you.